Now to Illinois, where Democratic Governor J.B. Pritzker signed a bill today that effectively makes Illinois the first state in the nation to end book bans. The law cuts funding to any public libraries or schools that do not adhere to the American Library Association's Library Bill of Rights, which prohibits the removal or restriction of reading materials due to partisan or personal disapproval.
That's right. Illinois just became the first state to take action against the massive wave of book bans sweeping the country. For more on the bill, let's hear from the big boy governor himself of Illinois, J.B. Pritzker.
The American Library Association cited 67 attempts to ban books in Illinois in 2022. One of those books is the memoir Gender Queer by Maya Kobabe, which explores non-binary gender identity. That effort failed. But how do you respond to parents who say that it should be up to them to decide what their children read?
Well, that's exactly what this bill does. This new law allows parents to make the decision about whether their children will be able to get that book and make the decision about whether they don't want to present that to their kids. So this isn't about taking things away. This is, I believe in freedom. I believe in the freedom to read and to understand and learn. And that's what libraries and librarians do. We should let librarians do the work that they have always done. They get to choose what books get put on the shelves, but they also are prohibited from, taking books off the shelves for political reasons.
Boy, does it feel good to be a resident of Illinois and have our governor making news for something that's not corruption. Woo. But unsurprisingly, of course, Illinois Republicans were not happy about this bill. House Minority Leader Tony McCombie wrote this in an emailed statement. He said, "I support local control. Our caucus does not believe in banning books, but we do believe that the content of books should be considered in their placement on the shelves," which is, if you couldn't tell, just a fancy way of him saying that he wants to ban books, because no matter what, the schools and the school districts are going to have control over what books are going on the shelves, just not the ability to ban or prohibit books outright. Anyway, the Illinois bill is very much necessary because a mind-boggling number of books are getting attacked by conservatives. Associated Press reported that more than 1,200 challenges were compiled by the American Library Association in 2022, nearly double the then record total from 2021, and by far the most since the ALA began keeping data 20 years ago. And Ben, isn't it just so ironic that these conservatives who love to talk about, it's just like 1984, this is like Fahrenheit 451, but they are literally the ones banning the books.
They are the most soft, snowflakey, afraid of everything, can't go outside, can't be exposed to a thought or an idea, group of people that crumble under the tiniest bit of criticism, the tiniest bit of challenging information, the tiniest bit of exposure to somebody different than they are possible. It's so embarrassing for them that these people are so fragile that they have to get their panties in a bunch and crumble like a ice cream cone in the wind, melting right down to the bottom of their soft, soggy cone to be able to exist in this world. I feel terrible for these people. How harmful ideas must be. They should probably try to insulate themselves from anybody from the outside world and keep inbreeding so that they don't have any outside genes affecting their gene pool. It's a smart way to go, fellas. Less teeth, less chromosomes, less evolution. You stick with you. Do it.
Less problems too, less to worry about, less brain capacity, less to worry about, you know what I'm saying? I think, what the governor said is true. This is the bill allows for parents to step in and have some autonomy over what their kids do or don't read. But for me, the funniest thing about this is that we live in an age, one, where paperback books are becoming less and less of like a generally consumed thing at all. And also, how many children just really love reading? Let's be serious. Like, I mean, yeah, you do have some kids that love to read, but generally, like, kids don't just love reading books like that. So, like, I'm gonna sneak off and read a book about cultural identity issues. Like, most children don't even know how to think about those things, especially if you're talking about like elementary or middle school settings. you know, maybe you might be starting to explore it. But again, it's like, if it's really that big of a deal, then just step up and be a parent. Step up and introduce some influence into your children's life and, you know, some discipline or whatever it is. You know, actually lead them, actually provide some insight. But too often these people, as Ben was pointing out, they have inbred insight. And so it just doesn't go very far. You know what I'm saying? So, but yeah, it's just really stupid. And it's also an incredible waste of political capital to try to ban books that nobody's reading anyway. Let's be serious.
Right. A lot of these people with these repressive opinions, they're lettuce, tomato, and meat because they're inbred.
You're right, I should have just kept up.
It needed to flow.
One thing I think is really interesting as we talk about this is the fact that this is sort of promoted as if there's a, you know, an influx of large groups of parents who want these books to be banned, when in fact, you know, and they're portrayed as grassroots movements, but in fact they're actually, most of these movements have ties to infamous conservative villains and mega donors like the Koch brothers. And let's look at this, you know, as a specific example, Moms for Liberty. The Guardian did some reporting on this group, and they found that Moms for Liberty groups are promoted on the website of Parents Defending Education, another conservative group. PDE's president, Nicole Neely, was previously the executive director of the Independent Women's Forum and worked at the Cato Institute, a right-wing think tank co-founded by Republican megadonor Charles Koch. The Intercept reported that the IWF has received large donations from Republican donor Leonard Leo. Moms for Liberty also appears to be affiliated with, or at least a frequent promoter of, the Heritage Foundation, a right-wing Koch-funded think tank. There's another group called No Left Turn in Education, what a clever name that is for your group. But they're a similar group to Moms for Liberty, and they are also promoted on this PDE website. According to The Guardian, again, No Left Turn in Education has links to deep-pocketed conservatives. The Milwaukee Journal reported that Alana Fishbein, No Left Turn in Education's founder, has provided free legal representation for parents wishing to challenge school districts. According to Journal, most of those lawyers are affiliated with the Liberty Justice Center and Pacific Legal Foundation, which received funding from the prominent GOP donor Dick Uhlhein, a Wisconsin-based billionaire. And that's a lot, but I still have one more example for you from the New York Times. The Keller Independent School District just outside of Dallas passed a new rule in November. It banned books from its libraries that include the concept of gender fluidity. The change was pushed by three new school board members elected in May with support from Patriot Mobile, a self-described Christian cell phone carrier, through its political action committee. Patriot Mobile poured hundreds of thousands of dollars into Texas school board races to promote candidates with conservative views on race, gender, and sexuality, including on which books children can access at schools. And if you think a cell phone provider called Patriot Mobile is actually genuinely bringing in enough revenue from selling their phone service to individuals that they could fund these races, I have a bridge to sell you. I mean, Jackson, it's not surprising to see that the same big moneyed interests that have been fighting these culture wars and pushing these culture wars are also funding these book banning bills. But, you know, it is interesting to see it just laid out in front of you how interconnected these orgs are.
Well, and also too, it's hilarious when liberty is actually the antithesis of the word, what they associate it with. Moms for Liberty, which means the ability to impose my narrow-mindedness onto everyone else. I mean, that's basically all it is. And the dumbest thing about it is these are issues that people could just choose to not think about. Now, that's not to say we have perfect control of our thoughts. Nobody can turn their minds off. You can't perfectly control what's in there. But some things, yeah, you can just choose to just keep yourself busy in other areas. Like, some people just need to go do something. You know what I'm saying? Like, while your kids, for real, like your kids at school having a good time, probably just playing with their friends, not thinking about any of this, like literally not thinking about any of these things. And you're just like tapping your pencil at work, not being productive. Like, oh, my kid might read a book that has gay people in it. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just so stupid. But again, the idea of freedom to them is their freedom to take freedom away from everybody else.
Exactly.
No, see, I disagree because I grew up watching a show called My Two Dads, and that show made me gay. It made me be very gay. it just changed the trajectory of my life. I wasn't able to discern a show from, you know, my own life. And obviously I'm kidding because that is very stupid. And I was able to somehow still turn out straight, believe it or not. I mean, it's the craziest idea in the world to think that exposure to an idea is gonna change somebody. So it's not even rooted in actual belief or fear. It's just rooted in hate. It's just, let's try to make that group feel small, make that group feel less than.
One thing I really like about that conservative line of thinking is that being gay is such an attractive idea that the mere exposure of the concept of gayness will be enough to convert people into being gay. I love the idea that it has this power. The mere knowledge of homosexuality is enough to grasp you and change the course of your life forever.
Yes, it's like a very spell. Powerful. It's a spell. It's kind of a vortex. You can't get out of it. Next, I understand Republicans are going to ban the word happiness because it has a penis in it.
And it also is related to the word gay, so we can't have any of that going on. You know what I'm saying? But the bottom line is, you know, like as a heterosexual man, like I don't think about men sexually because I'm not gay, and it's not more complicated than that. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, there's something to be said about being so obsessed with the idea of homosexuality if you aren't.
I grew up as a boy named Ben, and the popular cream or ointment if you hurt yourself back then was called Ben Gay. Literally it was called Ben Gay. And I came out not gay. So there's nothing more overt than seeing on billboards and signs and stores, Ben Gay. And I ended up straight. If anything proves you can survive exposure to direct program messaging, it's that.
Despite the obstacles, you still made it to the top of the hill.
I made it to the top of the hill if the top of the hill is dating women who usually aren't interested.
And I'll just end this by saying, as a queer person, I didn't become gay because I watched Santana and Britney kiss each other on Glee. I was gay long before that. That was just when I realized that I was in love with Naya Rivera.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.